Everybody has only seen a few photos of the attack on September 11th. These photos make it easy to believe that a few Arabs attacked America, and that the airplane crashes and the fires caused the buildings to collapse. However, when we take a close look at how the buildings collapsed, it appears as if explosives were used. For example, dust shot out of a few windows far below the collapsing area. This dust is caused by extremely high pressure. When we look closely at the area that is collapsing, we find dust shooting out of every window on the entire floor at the same time. The towers had a steel frame, so the only way they could collapse is if thousands of joints were broken. The towers collapsed in less than 10 seconds, which is an average of 10 floors every second. Next time you see a 10-story building, imagine the entire building crumbling in 1 second. The only buildings that collapse this quickly are the buildings that are destroyed with explosives. We were told that the collapse began when one floor broke and the pieces fell to the floor below it. Those pieces shattered that floor and so on all the way down. However, when the pieces hit the floor below, they will slow down slightly, and some of their energy will be used to break the floor. Therefore, there should be a delay every time the pieces hit a floor. The towers had 110 floors, so if it took 1 second for each floor to be crushed, that would be 110 seconds. However, the seismic data and video show that the North Tower collapsed in only 8.4 seconds. The collapse started at about the 94th floor. If you were to drop a rock from the 94th floor, it would hit the ground about 8.4 seconds later. This means that the pieces of the building were falling as fast as objects fall through the air. How can objects crash through steel and concrete floors as fast as they fall through the air? There is only one explanation. Explosives were placed in these buildings before the attack. The collapse of the North Tower started when explosives at the 94th floor were detonated. The explosives were timed so that the floors were shattered before the rubble contacted it. The pieces of the building fell in only 8.4 seconds because none of the pieces crashed into a floor. We were told that fire caused the towers to collapse, but no large building has ever collapsed from a fire. This 32-story skyscraper in Madrid, Spain, is a good example. The fire became so intense that it spread from one floor to the next, causing the building to look like a torch. This fire was much larger than the fire at the World Trade Center. The next morning, there were still a few fires in the lower floors. Everything inside the building had been burned. Some sections of the building broke. A few portions at the top of the building collapsed. However, the building remained standing, and it continued to support a large construction crane at the top. By comparison, the fire at the South Tower was so small that it never spread to the other side of the tower. We know that a few firefighters made it up to the fire zone of the South Tower because they used their handheld radios to send reports of their arrival. They said there were only a few areas with fire. Obviously, the fire was too small to kill firefighters, but we are supposed to believe that it was large enough to cause the buildings to collapse after burning for only 56 minutes. The fire in Madrid was much more severe, and it burned all night, but it did not cause the building to collapse.